So I'd like to welcome Sister Jayanti here today. She is the European Director of the Brahma Kumaris and the Director of the Brahma Kumaris National Coordinating Office in London. She has been a spiritual leader and teacher for 50 years, dedicating her life to self-transformation and the service of humanity. Since 2019, she has headed the BK delegation to the UNFCCC and has spoken internationally on the link between consciousness and climate change. In 2018, she led early morning meditation sessions at the World Economic Forum in Davos in January and at the European Commission's EU Sustainable Energy Week Policy Conference in Brussels in June. Sister Jayanti, welcome. It is a pleasure to have you here today and to have this talk. I thought we could start off with a question on hope. Now, in this times of coronavirus pandemic, our hope is perhaps one of the emotions that has been tested at the very limit of existence that we have. Our life, which is already uncertain, has been plunged into more uncertainty, and people are struggling today for something to hold on to. So can you please share your thoughts on how can we hold on to hope in these trying times? What can we find hope in?
Thank you for the question. And yes, I think it is only spirituality that can offer hope for the future. Because if you look at things just on the physical, mundane level, then there seems to be a lot of chaos and darkness around everywhere. And I mean that literally globally. And so when I'm able to keep my consciousness above the mundane, and explore that dimension, which is a dimension of spirit, it's in that awareness that I can find hope. And my own experience tells me that I'm something more than just this physical body. I am that inner being, the being of light. And when I connect with myself in that awareness, I realize that there are always changes that are going to happen. And maybe there was a time when things were okay, they were settled, and now they're not. It's very dark around me everywhere. But I know for sure it's not even just a hope. It's a reality of understanding that after the darkness, there has to be the light. And so what is ahead of us is a period of light. But I have to allow that light to shine within myself now, even though all around me there's darkness. And spirituality gives me the awareness that when I have that light shining within, in which I can see below the surface and above the mundane, going deeper but also higher, then in that awareness, yes, I know that things are going to be better.
I'm very keen to explore this idea further. Can you please guide us on how we can actually embed spirituality in our day-to-day life and actually use this as a way of, you know, moving forward day-to-day?
On a day-to-day basis, what is it that I'm searching for? Probably I'd say I'm looking for peace. Some people would say, no, peace isn't enough. I want happiness. Some would say, well, more important than that is love. Some would say, no, justice and truth is more important. So I would say all of these are absolutely vital. They're part of human life. And this should be the way human life can be and should be. And where do we find these things? They're not outside somewhere. You can't go to a supermarket and buy a tin of peace. You can buy peace, but you can't buy peace. You can't find happiness in all the things externally. If you're finding happiness in the sun shining, well, tomorrow it's going to be raining. And so you're going to let the weather dictate your mood. Well, some people do. But you can see that all of these things that are external actually don't give me the things that I'm looking for. And it's very interesting that we forget to look inside. We keep thinking you're going to find these things outside. And spirituality is saying, go within, go inside. And when you go inside, you're going to find all the things that you've ever looked for. And you'll find that contentment and joy. And once you've found that within yourself, then you're going to be able to share it in every interaction you have around you, whether it's your family, whether it's your colleagues at work, whether it's your friends. But you need to have that state of contentment and fulfillment within. So that is life every single day, every single moment.
Thank you, sister. Absolutely. I mean, I know personally, I would love to have that sort of clarity of mind to guide me every day so that I don't feel isolated, or I don't let these feelings of, you know, panic or anxiety that's being brought upon me because of this pandemic and all the uncertainty around me affect me. But, you know, I am living in a real world. We're all living in a real world. We have jobs. We are working from home. We've got stress. We've got schedules to keep and meetings to have. And so in this sort of, you know, stressful environment where we're trying to, you know, earn our daily bread, so to speak, how do we imbibe spirituality practically? Are there any particular tools that we can use?
Think about your telephone, your mobile. If you don't charge it every single day, what's it going to do for you? Nothing. It's a wonderful instrument, a very expensive, fancy instrument even maybe, but it's of no value. Why? Because it's discharged. Now, here I am as a human being doing all the things that you talk about, absolutely true. And add to that a pinch of uncertainty, add to that this whole question about redundancy, unemployment, all the ghosts that are hanging around us today. But if I have my inner battery charged, I'll be able to deal with each one of these aspects one by one by one by one. When I get them all muddled up and it's all a mess, it's a spaghetti inside my head, it's so complex, it's so complicated, I don't know where to begin. But if I can recharge my own inner battery, and after that recharging, especially in the morning, then I look at what the day holds for me, and there'll be uncertainties within that, but at least I know I've got my children, I've got my partner, I've got my work, and so can I now balance out everything and manage everything peacefully, calmly? If I'm not at peace with myself, if my inner battery is discharged, more stress, more anxiety, and more of a mess and chaos. Is that how I want to live my life? I don't. What I'd like to do is to recharge. And it doesn't cost a penny. It costs you time. Time is actually more valuable than money. And so what I need to do is to just sit quietly and talk to myself. You're not going crazy. If I talk to myself and I don't know that I'm doing it, that's crazy. But if I talk to myself and I know that I'm doing it and I'm doing it consciously, that is wisdom. Why? Because when I have an inner dialogue with myself, I begin to go very deep within and I connect with these treasures that we spoke about earlier, the peace, the love, the truth, etc. It's all there within me, but I can't access it because my attention is out there. Now I go within, have an inner dialogue, and I know I can keep my calm state of mind, no matter whether there's a few children running around me, or maybe it's timetables that are stressful, but I approach it with that state of mind in which I am in charge of myself. And I'm not a puppet being pulled by circumstances here and there, but I'm truly with my own inner being. I'm the master of my world, the master of my own emotions and feelings. And then I can treat every single step of the journey through the day, not only with love, kindness, and compassion, which is absolutely vital now, especially now, but I can also treat it with joy. Every moment can be a joy of life, or every moment can be a tragedy. And it's up to me to be able to have that inner strength, to be able to have that resource within myself to increase my own inner capacity. You know, people talk about capacity building, but this is building up my own inner resources so that then I have the power, the spiritual strength to manage all the things that I'm dealing with. And I'll do it with a smile, and I'll do it with love and joy, so that then whatever it is I do, it's done to the best of my ability.
Such a wonderful thought. Particularly, I love this idea of looking inward and finding our inner voice and perhaps even our inner light. I mean, we are at the Diwali fest after all, which is the festival of light, and finding this illumination that's coming from inside. And I was really hoping, I'm sure all our viewers are also hoping, that you will be able to guide us through meditation perhaps now, and help us find that inner light, or at least help us try and find that path towards, you know, having this inner dialogue with ourselves and achieving this clarity of mind that you so beautifully demonstrated and talked about right now.
I'll be happy to guide a meditation. And even if you've never meditated before, that's absolutely fine. So let's go on a journey, and I'll share my own thoughts and invite you to follow those ideas. If you've got something cooking on the stove, I suggest you turn it off for a few minutes. But apart from that, there's no other preparation needed except that you sit comfortably.
Thank you, sister.
I go on an inner journey and look at my thoughts, and simply watching my thoughts slows down the speed. And now I select one thought, the thought of peace. I hold peace in my awareness. I go deeper and deeper within. And I realize that there's a space within me where only I can enter. I touch this inner sanctuary. And in this sacred space, I find peace. And as I connect with the peace within, the light within is ignited. I am that diya. I am that flame, that light. I am light. I am peace. I hold this awareness of who I truly am, and the peace and the light radiate out into this room and out further beyond. The light and the peace radiate out into the city and out into the world, and light surrounds our planet, and peace returns to this home of ours. I hold this awareness of my eternal form, of peace, of light. I come back to the awareness of the physical dimension that now aware of the light that I am, and the being of peace that I am. Om Shanti. And as I step back into the physical dimension, I keep that flame ignited, so that I can walk through the darkness with this light guiding me. Thank you.
Thank you, sister.